Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. And can I thank the Secretary of State for advance sight of his statement? As the Secretary of State has outlined, in five separate shootings across 3 days in August 1971 in the Ballymurphy estate in West Belfast, 10 innocent civilians were shot dead, 9 by the armed forces, with evidence unable to conclusively determine in a tenth. Amongst them, a priest, a mother of 8, and a former soldier who had fought and was injured in World War II. 57 children left without a parent, their lives forever changed. Yet the trauma of their murders was undoubtedly compounded by what followed. Families prevented from finding comfort by lies told about their loved ones, which have haunted them down the decades. A fight for the truth hampered through entirely inadequate investigations and wholly unjustifiable obstacles. Who cannot therefore be struck by the dignity and tenacity of those families who, in the face of those obstacles, have fought for the truth and finally, this week, been vindicated? The conclusions of Justice Keegan were clear and irrefutable. Those who lost their lives were posing no threat. Their deaths were without justification. They were Francis Quinn, Father Hugh Mallon, Noel Phillips, Joan Connolly, Daniel Teggart, Joseph Murphy, Eddie Doherty, John Laverty, Joseph Corr, John McKerr. An 11th man, Paddy McCarthy, a youth worker, died from a heart attack. That families have had to wait for so long to clear their name is a profound failure of justice and one we must learn from. Because as the Secretary of State has said, many more families are still fighting for answers. People like Cathy McCann, who in 1990 was the sole survivor of a provisional IRA bomb in Armagh, in which a nun and 3 policemen were killed. 21 years earlier, her father had been killed by the auxiliary police force, the B Specials. This ongoing failure to find the truth is an open wound which ties Northern Ireland perpetually to the past. Burying the truth, refusing to prosecute or investigate crimes has not worked in the 23 years since the signing of the Belfast Good Friday Agreement. So how can anyone in this House look victims like Cathy in the eye and tell her she must move on? The government gave victims like Cathy McCann their word. Through the Stormont House Agreement, they promised to establish a comprehensive system to look at all outstanding legacy cases through effective investigations and a process that would, where possible, deliver the truth and the prospect of justice. Yet last Wednesday night, victims found out on Twitter that the government intends to tear up that plan and provide an effective amnesty to those who took lives. And from the statement today, we are no closer to understanding the government's policy to dealing with the legacy of the past. The lessons of the past are clear. Addressing legacy through a unilateral imposition of an amnesty from Westminster without the faintest hint of consultation with victims, the support of communities, any political party in Northern Ireland or the Irish government would be impossible to deliver. It would make reconciliation harder. And it would not achieve what the government claim they want. Any process that remains open to legal challenge will invite test cases and more veterans back through the courts. Let me finish with a word, Mr. Speaker, on the Prime Minister's actions, or lack of them, over the last 2 days. In the aftermath of the Bloody Sunday inquiry, David Cameron came to this House and apologised in a statement. He didn't brief apologies from disputed calls with politicians. He took full responsibility. Where is the Prime Minister today, and why has he not publicly apologised to the Ballymurphy families and to this House? Will he take responsibility as Prime Minister and show the victims the respect they so obviously deserve? Victims, Mr. Speaker, like those who lost loved ones at Ballymurphy, have been let down for far too long. Ministers should bear in mind the words of one victim I spoke with yesterday as they work through the next steps of legacy. I just want to know what happened. I want to know my dad's life meant something. I just want the truth.